Just bring in the Chief Science Advisor for Operation Warp Speed, Dr. Moncef Slaoui. Dr. Slaoui, thank you for joining us again this morning. Let's begin with that big news out of Britain. Now that Britain has approved the use of the vaccine, are you confident that same approval is going to come here in the next 2 weeks?
Well, listen, it's great news. I think that an independent regulatory body that outside of the U.S., outside of the context in which these vaccines have been developed, has come to a positive decision regarding the Pfizer vaccine. I would expect the FDA to reach a similar conclusion. The MHRA, the UK agency, is a very, very high-level type of agency comparable to the FDA in terms of quality and depth of its assessment. But of course, as you know, the operation is totally separated from the FDA as far as judgments are concerned, and you know, things will follow their course. But I hope by the 10th or the 11th of December, Pfizer vaccine is approved.
The CDC advisory panel was nearly unanimous in recommending that healthcare workers, long-term care residents, get the vaccine first. But there was one dissent by Dr. Helen Talbot, who was worried about giving the vaccine to long-term care residents. She said that it has not been studied in this particular population. Is that a valid concern?
Well, listen, I know, for instance, that for the Moderna vaccine, there were more than 7,500 subjects that were older than 65 years of age with comorbidities, some of which may have very well been in long-term care facilities or in a similar health status as those in long-term care facilities. So I think there's actually quite a rich set of data to the extent also that the efficacy could be demonstrated in that particular age group as being close to 90%. I think the data are there to immunize those who suffer the most from this disease with deaths, which are the older people, and those are exposed. I think the process has now started, and I suppose the CDC and ACIP and ultimately the HHS secretary has until the approval by the FDA to come to a final recommendation.
We asked our audience for questions about the vaccine, and many are concerned about whether enough people will actually get the vaccine to put an end to the pandemic.
Yes, it is a big concern that there has been so much, frankly, politicization of the development process during the previous months that created a high level of hesitancy, I would say, and decreased trust into the process. I'd like to really tell the American people that no corners have been cut. The development has been done very quickly because we had great science to allow us to do all the discovery work in weeks rather than in years. And then the clinical work, the most important part that demonstrates the effectiveness of the vaccine and its safety, has been done to a higher standard than what's done normally in larger number of people. The long-term safety over years of these vaccines, we don't know yet, just because the pandemic is so high that we're going to need to use them earlier to save lives and get us back to our normal life. But we'll be assessed and studied on an ongoing basis. So really, people, please keep your ears open and your mind open. Don't make up your mind. Listen to the experts, those people that you trust, after they see the data, and then make up your mind. And I think if you do that, most Americans will conclude this is an insurance against this virus. This is what will get us out of this pandemic.
Certainly hope you're right. Dr. Slaoui, thanks again for your time this morning.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.